April 25th, we will be at Staten Island at the Supreme Court House at 5 o'clock. We will be out there alongside of Garner Way Foundation, alongside with Answer Coalition. Now, I understand what you guys are going through out there, so we understand we will be there in your place to support you, because we understand it's not safe out there in Staten Island, and your safety is what we need. We need you here. If it wasn't, like I said, I can't thank you enough, because you even opened my eyes. I was one that, when Trayvon Martin died, I was pissed off I was in the street for a day. And then when Sean Bell pissed off in the street, and then it went away. This is the first time that I've been out here and stayed out here because you opened my eyes. So thank you, Ramsey.
That's right. And he did it in the most right-wing borough of New York City. The most right-wing borough. Pantaleo already had dirt on him before this killing of Eric Garner. He got brought up on internal charges 2 times in the previous 2 years. For different things, like, you know, pulling people over, making them undress, doing...
Broken windows, yeah.
Yeah, broken windows theory. It's, yeah, he's bad news. Yeah. They also said they were going to retrain the 35,000 police officers we have now. Yeah. They knew Pantaleo was corrupt and guilty of sin, you know, 2 and 3 years ago. So this is just window dressing, what they're saying now. Sorry about that.
No, go ahead. There was 2 other brothers. One brother was at a psych emergency at this hospital called Barely Breathing. But they call it Barely Seat, but it's Barely Breathing. And he was there in 2002, and he didn't want to be at the psych ward, right? In the emergency, and they knew that there was a problem. And he went out and he ran, and they sent the cops after him. Instead of going after them themselves, the cops got him, and they choked him also. So this is not something new. This has been going on not only on Staten Island, but throughout the United States. Now, as far as Ramsey is concerned, Ramsey, where's Ramsey?
Right here. Right here.
Oh, there. Okay, there you go, Ramsey. I can't even put it out there, but you did something that most of us, and I'm saying most of us, like 99%, would have never done. And I'm quite sure, you know what, you did not know what you were getting into, and you signed up on this, right? Now, bottom line is, Eric has known Ramsey for a long time. They were friends. They put it out there that he was just a passerby. He wasn't a passerby. And they were after Eric for a long time. People don't know that, and there was a past where the cops came after him time and time again. He was even strip searched to the point when they even did a cavity search on him in the street.
Yep, in the street.
Okay? He had a case against them, but they just let it go, let it go, let it go. On the day that he was lynched to death, the cops were looking at him. People don't know that on Staten Island, they were right up the street, and they had asked this cab driver to move his cab so they could have a clear view of Eric. So when he stopped people from fighting, they thought they were coming down to congratulate whatever case it be, but they went straight for him. So Eric was a target from day one.
Absolutely.
And that's why he was saying, no more, no more. This stops
today.
Now. Okay? And we're saying, no more, no more. This stops now. And as quiet as it's kept, Ferguson didn't happen because of Ferguson. Ferguson happened because of Ramsey. Because they didn't know what was happening in the past. But when they found out because of what Ramsey did, that's when they found out. And that's what gave them the guts to stand up. So we're standing up. And we're going to do for you what we should have been doing a long time ago. Protecting your ass, okay? Whether you like it or not. Okay? Right, Ramsey?
Yeah.
Okay. Aunt Shirley from the Forgotten Borough of Staten Island.
Woo!
Thank
Woo!
You. Thank Woo! You, Sister Shirley. Woo!
I just want to say, Ramsey, you're very pivotal. You may not realize this in this moment, but we consider you a very pivotal figure in this, because in reality, without you, I wouldn't still be going hard in these streets. You know, a lot of people that I've met along the way, I've been at almost every march, they say they saw that Eric Garner video on TV and they were horrified at what happened, and that got them out in the streets. We were all, QB, me, Dorian, all, a lot of people here were at a big march we did in Harlem. I think it was November or December. We were all out there. It was freezing cold.
They're all the same thing.
Yeah, they're running together now.
It's all interrelated.
But there was an old guy, 84 years old, on a walker, marching with us. He marched with us for hours. He was with us through the streets of Harlem.
That's
intense. So, you know, camera crew caught wind and wanted to interview him. So I was walking alongside of him, and they asked him what brought him out. He said, "I saw Eric Garner, you know, that video on TV, and I can't believe that, you know, I marched on Washington, and now in 2014, you know, we're dealing with the exact same thing."
Yeah.
You know, our good friend Babby, you know, and she's an ally, she's, you know, Caucasian American, and her boyfriend and I, we asked them recently, you know, what made you get so deeply involved, because they are deeply in the movement. She said, "I saw that video, and I just had to do so. I had to figure out where there was a march, where there was a rally, you know, where I can go." So, you know, 10 years from now, you'll be in history books in school, and people will be reading about you. You know, so I just want to let you know that. If anyone else wants to speak and say a few words to Ramsey, then please put me.
It would have been easy for the police to cover it up had it not been for Ramsey.
Yeah, they would have covered it up.
I want to thank everyone for supporting the GoFund. It went very, very well.
Yeah.
As well as anybody who decided to call the district attorney, make those calls, and put the person you made, because you bring home my nephew. We're the freedom fighters. And I just want to let everybody know that we're not going to stand down. We're not going to sit down. We're going to keep standing up.
That's right.
Ramsey's gonna keep standing up. We're gonna continue standing up until there's justice. There's not gonna be no peace.
Exactly.
Amen. Eric Garner's last words was, "I can't breathe."
That's right.
He said it 11 times.
That's right.
I know we're out here tonight, today, this afternoon, this evening, early evening, to welcome Ramsey back home. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, so, yeah, back to, we're here for Ramsey. We're also here for Eric Garner. Because if it wasn't for Ramsey, we wouldn't know about Eric Garner.
That's right.
And we wouldn't know Eric Garner's last words, which was, "I can't breathe." Eric Garner yelled, "I can't breathe," 11 times. I would like everybody to yell, "I can't breathe," 11 times. One.
I can't breathe.
Two.
I can't breathe.
Three.
I can't breathe.
Four.
I can't breathe.
Five.
I can't breathe.
Six.
I can't breathe.
Seven.
I can't breathe.
Eight.
I can't breathe.
Nine.
I can't breathe.
Ten.
I can't breathe.
11.
I can't breathe.
Freedom fighters.
Peace and justice for Eric Garner.
Peace and justice. Thank you.
So, yeah, so I just asked.
4.5.
Okay. I just asked, because we've done this so pretty much.
In Ramsey Orta, we are going to do a die-in for 6 minutes, and that is the amount of time that they left our brother, Eric Garner, laying in the street without any kind of intervention, CPR or anything. I think they did nudge him with his foot, if I'm not mistaken, but nothing was tried. So if we can just go ahead and find a spot, and we're going to do a die-in.
EMTs were less than 6 feet away watching Eric die.
Yep.
Desensitized to humanity.
Doesn't get any more despicable.
Let me set the timer.
Thank
you. Who's keeping clock? I got it. All right. These police killers.
I can feel their spirit.
I feel their spirit.
Cause I remember all the people.
These police killed.
I can feel their spirit.
I can feel.
Ramsey, we need you to come to the front. Oh, come over here. This is from all of us. We had an amazing artist, Gabby. She couldn't be here today. She's out of town, but she painted this for you.
Oh, wow. Oh my God.
Anything,
please.
I'm more than happy to.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's already done.
Please.
Just hold this beat.
Well, I just want to say thank you for everybody coming out here and coming to see me and supporting my friend Eric. And that's pretty much it.
Thank you.
We want you all the way, young brother.
Anyone else want to say anything before I'm
When I say hero, you say Orta. Hero!
Orta!
Hero!
Orta!
When I say hero, you say Orta. Hero!
Orta!
Hero!
Orta!
Hero!
Orta!
Hero!
Orta!
You didn't know you look so good, huh?
That great chance. The people united will never be defeated, but if they keep us divided, we know we're being cheated.
Okay, so come lead us. Come lead us in that. That's a good one. I can't remember that right now.
The people united will never be defeated if they keep us divided. We know we're being cheated. The people united will never be defeated if they keep us divided. We know that we're being cheated. The people united will never be defeated if they keep us defeated. We know that we've been cheated. The people united will never be defeated if they keep us divided. We know we're being cheated.
Let me explain to you what this is about. They are taking the deep pocket money advantage away from police departments and cities. So where the cities have outspent you, and where you haven't been able to really fight and have your voice heard, where you've lost cases or you've taken settlements where you shouldn't have, this group seeks to level the playing field. I also encourage you to follow WeCan'tBreathePack.org. Because we're going to be fighting, we're going to be identifying legislation and also pushing for legislation that is going to help champion our movement. We have to elect candidates that are in our interest.
James Lane!
James Lane! So if you're in Staten Island, if you're in that district, you need to go out and support these candidates. Again, this is a move, this is a war that's being fought on all fronts. So we can't just be out in the streets. It's important. But there are other pieces of this puzzle that have to be filled in. I encourage you to do that.
One
God bless you all.
One struggle, many fronts. That's right.
Amen.